Good afternoon. On behalf of the family, we welcome you to this service for the life and celebration of the life of Joyce and the mourning of her passing. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we come to you with heavy hearts. We come to you, Lord, seeking your healing, seeking your grace, seeking you to wrap your arms around us and give us comfort during this time. Father, may your name be glorified today. May the gospel be proclaimed. And may we walk out of this celebration of life service transformed in your image. For it's in your name that we pray. Amen.
Amen.
John 14, 1 through 6 says, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and I will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. And you know the way to where I'm going." And Thomas said to him, "Lord, we don't know where you're going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Joyce Ann Fritz was born September 12, 1948, and she passed to eternity May 28, 2022. From Marquette Heights, Joyce Ann Fritz, 73, was born in 1948. She was the daughter of William Everett and Wanda Faye Farn Fritz, Sr. Her parents preceded her in death. She was also preceded in death by one brother, William Everett Fritz, Jr. Surviving are her one son, Troy, and Laura Owens of Casper, Wyoming, one grandson, Troy, T.J. Owens, Jr., three sisters, Phyllis Fritz, Mary and Randy Bumbelow, Sr., both of Marquette Heights, and Linda Lester Miller of Galesburg, one brother, David and Denise Fritz of Hanna City, her sister-in-law, Earlene Susie Fritz of Edelstein, and several nieces and nephews. Joyce was a 1966 graduate of Farmington High School, where she graduated in the top 10. She worked 20 years as a personal banker at Hergett Bank in Pekin. She also worked for Trevoli State Bank and for the First State Bank in St. Charles, Missouri. Joyce enjoyed spending time with her family and was a faithful volunteer at TAPS. She also loved to walk. Wish I loved to walk. She was a member of Bartonville Christian Church. Her memorial service is being held at this place and at this time. A private burial will be at the Smithville Cemetery in Hanna City. Any memorial contributions you would like to make, please make to the Tazewell Animal Protective Society in Pekin. I found a few passages in Scripture that I thought described Joyce after I met with family. One of them comes out of Proverbs chapter 31. It's verse 26 and verse 30 and 31. God's word says this: "When she speaks, her words are wise, when she gives instructions with kindness. But a woman who fears the Lord will be greatly praised. Reward her for all she has done. Let her deeds publicly declare her praise." Music was picked out for today, and music is often picked out for services like this. But what I liked about today is all the songs were chosen with a purpose. They were chosen because they were songs that Joyce loved and Joyce lived. So the first song that we're going to play today wasn't chosen by mistake, or it wasn't chosen quickly by the family. They were deliberate choices made by the family to communicate who Joyce is. If anyone was sad, upset, or in conflict, Joyce would say, "You need to sing, Jesus Loves Me." comfort in times like this is critical to our souls. As Christians, we know we're to mourn differently than those who are not Christians. It's an honor to be here today to share in this celebration of life. The Journey Church is praying for all the family of Joyce. It's an honor to be here today. Even when days like this are hard, we can call this a celebration of life. That's exactly what it is. It's a celebration of who Joyce is. But it still hurts. It's still painful. I met with a family this week, not only to talk about what today needed to look like, but also to try to get a picture of who Joyce is. I met Joyce briefly several times, but never had the opportunity to really get to know her. And we sat down and we talked about who Joyce is, and I want to be intentional today and say that Joyce is, because Joyce is more alive today than she's ever been. There's something that is unique about Joyce, and I was blessed to see that immediately with the family. She's loved. She's loved because of the God who loved her, and she's loved for who she is. You can tell how a person lived by the memories of the ones they leave behind. Joyce is a peaceful, loving, and tender believer in Jesus Christ. And Joyce is singing to him right now as we're in this place. She's a woman that was able to find good in everybody. I should have talked to her more. She was an animal lover, a huge animal lover. In fact, I got given by the family some of the notes that Joyce had penned before her memory started to slip away from her. And in that, I could see from the very beginning, Joyce made comments about all the animals that were in her life. She loved animals. She recorded the impact they had in her life and how it made her feel when the animals were a part of her life and when the animals went away. I received, again, some notes that she had and before her memory failed her, and you could hear all the way through all the notes from the very beginning of it. You could hear almost the tender heart in which she had written those notes. Things that had happened to her, you could hear just the forgiveness in her letters. You could sense that about her. You could sense the spirit that she had and who she is. All the way through all of those pages that I received, a couple things stood out to me, and it was important for the family too. They talked about this as well. When we were in my office this week, she was so loving. And when I saw the note and I read the notes, a couple things came across to me, that Joyce was meek and she was gentle. In a world today, meekness and gentleness can be seen as weakness. But it's not. Meekness and gentleness was displayed to us in Jesus Christ. We've seen that. And you can see those qualities in Joyce as well. How wonderful testimony that is. Now, grief hits us all differently, right? Some of us cry, some of us get angry. Some of us push it down and we ignore it. Some of us try to not feel. Some of us scream out in agony. There's some that fall apart in tears, and some that will hide their tears even from themselves. However you grieve, I want you to understand this afternoon that our Heavenly Father grieved as well. Our Heavenly Father understood that it's unfair. Joyce's sickness was unfair. There's nothing we can say to make that right or okay. It simply was unfair. But the comfort we have is we know that our Savior lived a life and things happened to him that was unfair as well. In Psalm 34:18, it says, "The Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves the crushed in spirit." God knows because he lost his son on the cross. Something that was unfair and cruel and painful. So he understands what we're feeling right now. He understands our grief. And he desires to comfort us during this time. And what's great about God is we have his word. And it's not just an instruction manual. His word is alive and active. And we see that. I picked these verses out today for this occasion, and it's from 1 Thessalonians 4:13-18. The Apostle Paul says this. He says, "And now, dear brothers and sisters, we want you to know what will happen to believers who have died, so you will not grieve like people who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and was raised to life again, we also believe when Jesus returns, God will bring back with him the believers who have died. Amen. We tell you this directly from the Lord. We who are still living when the Lord returns will not meet ahead of those who have died. For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a commanding shout, with the voice of an archangel, with the trumpet call of God. First, the believers who have died will rise from their graves, and then together with them, we who are still alive and remain on this earth will be caught up in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and then we'll be with the Lord forever." Then the Apostle Paul ends these passages with these words. He says, "So encourage each other with these words." We see the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. We can find comfort in the words Paul is giving to us today. We understand that what will happen when a Christian passes on from this life before coming of the Lord. We Christians don't have to wonder about life after death. That's been answered for us. We have God's word on that. When Paul, through the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, concerning the resurrection, gives us these assurances and comforts, we can find rest, hope, faith, and truth in these. In a world today that's just full of all kinds of confusion and full of lies and full of things that always end, we have something eternal in our Savior Jesus Christ. We can trust God's word. We can find comfort in his word. Those who are not believers in Jesus Christ, this is your opportunity. Your opportunity to find rest in him, to find peace in him, to find a Savior in him. There is no hope outside of Christ. And my hope is that you will place Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Apostle Paul says in Romans 1:16, "For I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it has the power of God and the salvation. For the word of God is quick and powerful." There's life in Scripture. I also received Joyce's Bible this week. I don't know how many Bibles as a pastor I receive that I open it up, and when I open it up, you can tell that it never had been opened. You can tell that it never been used. That wasn't the case here. As I flip through the pages, you could see underlines and notes, and I couldn't read the notes. Joyce's Bible's no different than mine, trust me. But you could see the notes. You could see the underlines. And then I found little post-it notes inside of it where she was going through something in her life, whatever it may have been. She was going through it, and you could see a little note, and you could see the scripture reference right next to it, and it was tucked neatly into that page. That told me all I needed to know. That told me that she sought out God and she communicated with God. and that she loved God. There's not a greater testimony than that. There's not a greater peace that comes than that. And Joyce had God's truth, and she has God's truth. We as Christians have hope because Christ is coming again. He's coming for us. He's going to bring with him his people who have died in the Lord. We don't lose believers in Jesus Christ. We didn't lose Joyce. You didn't lose your mom and your sister. You didn't lose her. You can't lose someone when you know where they're at. And we know exactly where she's at. Paul tells us we have hope as Christians because the dead will rise. He tells us that Christ will return in the air with a trumpet call. I believe we're closer and closer to hear that trumpet blow. We have hope as Christians because of the reunion that we're going to have with one another. If you're a believer in Jesus Christ, you will see Joyce again. This isn't goodbye for eternity. This is goodbye for a while. You will be worshiping arm in arm with Joyce in heaven. No more having to say goodbye. No more memory loss. No more pain. The meeting will be everlasting because of Jesus Christ on the cross. Death is a fact of life. Death is not an accident, it's an appointment. We're told that in Hebrews. We as believers have a wonderful assurance and hope because of Jesus Christ and his resurrection. He conquered death on our behalf, and he is coming again. We got to the end of our meeting this week. And I asked the family, the brother and sisters were around, and I asked the family, I said, do me a favor if you would. I said, I just want one word. Just one word to describe who Joyce is. And it was so interesting to me to hear that. It was so interesting to me because you can tell exactly who Joyce is. You could see it. You could see who she is, and they started talking, and they start saying the one word, and they had to think about it a little bit. They had to think a little bit because I only gave them one word. And they started saying who she was, and it reminded me of Galatians 5. It reminds me of the fruit of the Spirit. And the words they were saying were words like love, loving, joyful, peaceful, good, faithful, gentle. The attributes they gave Joyce were the attributes that we find in a believer in Jesus Christ. How wonderful a picture and how beautiful a moment that was. Joyce loved music and singing. However, it was said that she couldn't carry a tune. I didn't say that. Don't throw anything at me. I didn't say that. Troy, this is your fault. I don't know you and we haven't met, but I'm just saying this is your fault, brother. When Troy was little, when mom would start singing, he would put his hands up to his ears and he would yell out, "No, mommy, no." We're going to talk later about that one. But a friend, her name was Nancy, told her that the Bible says to make a joyful noise to the Lord. So she would sing out and celebrate with music. Family and friends, she's singing and celebrating with music as we sit here right now. With that, let's play the second song the family chose, Singing with the Saints. Another passage of scripture that I selected for today, I also came to from the conversations I had with family. It's found in Matthew 25, 34 through 40. Jesus says these words, "When the king will say to those on his right, 'Come, who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from creation of this world. For I was hungry and you fed me. I was thirsty and you gave me a drink. I was a stranger and you invited me into your home. I was naked and you gave me clothing. I was sick and you cared for me. I was in prison and you visited me.' Then these righteous ones will reply, 'Lord, when did we ever see you hungry or feed you, or thirsty and give you something to drink, or a stranger and show you hospitality, or naked and gave you clothing? When did we ever see you sick or in prison and visit you?' And the king will say, 'I tell you the truth, when you did it to the one of the least of my brothers and sisters, you were doing it to me.'" I heard that Joyce found the good in everybody and that she was nice to a fault. That's not a fault. That's not a fault at all. That's a beautiful picture of who we are called to be. Again, Joyce loved all kinds of music. When she would lie down in the afternoon, we always played a CD. Some of her favorites were Lee Greenwood's God Bless America, old folk songs such as Michael Row the Boat Ashore, and Trace Atkins' Badonka Donk. Oh, I wish I would have conversation sooner. I would have called her out on that one. That is awesome. Sorry. And of course, Christian music. Her all-time favorite and testimony was Amazing Grace. She loved that song so much. Some of the lines to that song were put on her headstone. Let's listen to that.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.
Phyllis wrote a letter to Joyce. Let me read it to you. Joyce's long struggle with posterior cortical atrophy is over. It may have taken her sight and her thought process, but it couldn't take away her love and caring for God, family, friends, country, and animals, especially border collies. As she frequently said, God spelled backwards as dog. Her strength, kindness, humor, and joy were everyday life lessons as she lived in this small piece of the world. Her strong trust and faith in our loving God has now led her to her heavenly reward, making music with the angels and rejoicing with our Lord. What a blessing to have a sister. See you later, Phil. I want to open up this time for family and friends to share anything that may be on your heart concerning Joyce. Please feel free to stand.
Joyce and Fritz, my big sister. She was here my whole life. My earliest memories of her involved her sitting on the heating register in the dark, talking to Alan, her boyfriend, on the phone. Being 10 years older than me, she was not my playmate, who I hung out with as a kid, except for the times we cruised Peoria, her, Mary, and I, and one time running out of gas coming home. She was a big sister. She was a savior at times, especially when she picked Mary and I up after staying with Grandma Farnham, and listened and laughed as we told her about our adventures and Grandma's terrible driving scaring us to death. She was my big sister. She was smart, hardworking, organized, and loving. She was my adventurous sister, living in Colorado and then St. Louis. She knew no strangers and could see the good in everyone, even those not deserving of it. She was my big sister. Even as the disease tried to consume her, she still sang Christian choruses, reminded me that Jesus Loves Me was her favorite, and laughing. She loved to laugh and always perked up talking about our family getting together. She always said, "We have so much fun." That was my sister. Joy, my memories of you are forever in my heart, and you are forever my big sister. I love you and will miss you till I join you in heaven.
Thank you. Who else? Anyone else? We have a fourth and final song today. These introductions to the songs are written by the family. It says this song was sang at our mom's funeral. Joyce initiated standing up and celebrating when it was played, and she wanted her own passing to be a celebration of her life and a praise that she is with the Lord. So as we do this last song in honor of her, and we all stand.
To our home on God just be sure.
Heavenly Father, thank you for allowing us to be here today and worship you. I pray, Father, that once again we walk out of this place transformed in the image of your Son, Jesus. I pray, Lord, as we celebrate the life of Joyce, we have peace. Peace of knowing that she is worshiping you in eternity, free of any illness. And Father God, I pray that if there's those in this room that don't know you, Father, I pray they fall to their knees and proclaim you as their Lord and Savior. Father God, until we meet with Joyce again, we ask for peace on our journey. We ask for peace from our pain. And we ask all of this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Lunch will be provided at Joyce's home church, Bartonville Christian Church on Pfeiffer Road in Bartonville. We ask you to go straight there and enjoy lunch and share memories of Joyce and with the family. Thank you.